trying to write a non-terminal statement. This is a, you know, this example of a simple grammar statement. You can see it can be if statement, while statement, begin statement, or for statement, right? So they are all starting with different keywords. Okay. So if the current token is if, we have to choose first production rule, right? If we are finding that, you know, it is starting with if, so we know that we have to just, you know, choose the first production rule. Okay. When we are trying to write the non-terminal statement, we can uniquely choose the production rule by just looking at the current token. Yes, current token is if, then we can simply looking at this, we can choose a correct grammar production rule. We eliminate the left recursion of the grammar and left factor it, but it may not be suitable for predictive parsing, not relevant grammar. So this is again a repetition of the same thing. Okay. Now next thing is there, that is called recursive predictive parsing. So what is recursive predictive parsing? We assume here that each non-terminals are a procedure. Okay, so every time we are finding a non-terminal, we are calling a procedure, which procedure will drive or generate the parse tree for this particular non-terminal symbol. So each non-terminal symbol corresponds to a process or procedure. Okay, now if we have A to A B small b, this is only the production rule for A. We all understand this. If this is there, then you can see here procedure A is going to run because we are starting with A. Now in procedure A, what are the things that are given here? Match the current token A with, you know, we have a parse table given where we have A somewhere and small somewhere. So we have to search for match A this cell, okay, and move to the next token. So if there is no other token, then it will simply get this B, right? So it is immediately called a procedure called B. Again, it will do the same thing, match current token with B. After, you know, calling B, the B will have a, you know, body like this. B is another procedure, and then it will return at this point, and again it will start match the current token with B, if it is matching the current token with this B, okay, and move to the next token. Then you move to the next token. Okay. So this is how recursive predictive parsing works. Now if you have set up rule like this, A to A, B, small b, and you have small b, capital A, capital B. In case of current token, if it is A, that means you got this production rule first, A to A, B, B. If your current token is A, then definitely you are with this production rule. Okay. Then definitely it will match the current token A and move to the next token, and after when it move, it will get this B, right? It will call B, and after doing all the action whatever defined in the B will also have a procedure like this, right? So it will call and return at this point, then again it will match the current token with this B, okay, and search the table that take the action, okay, and move to next token. This is one happen. Another thing, if your first token you encounter is small b, that means it is going with A to small a b this rule, right? So in this case, what will happen? Match the current token with B, make sure move to the next token will be A. So here you can see it is going to be a recursion, because A is called a procedure A, and we are already in a procedure A. So from here the call is going there. Okay, so this is a recursion, right? And after at the end of the recursion, again it will stop at this point, and then it will call procedure B. Understand? This is the reason it is called recursive predictive parsing. Okay, recursive predictive parsing also have some more things to know. When to apply epsilon production, because you will have epsilon production like this, then what we will do here, we have not spoken about epsilon. No, what will happen if A to epsilon is given, then nothing is defined here, right, in the procedure. So when to apply the epsilon procedure, here you can see A to epsilon is a rule. If all other production fail, we should apply an epsilon procedure. For example, if the current token is A or B, we may apply the epsilon procedure production. Okay, most correct choice is, when it is going to be most correct choice, we should apply epsilon production for a non terminal A when the current token is in the follow of A. Okay, so this is important to know. Okay, that most correct choice for epsilon production is that when the current input symbol, say it is A maybe, okay, and this is in follow A, then we can choose this epsilon production as a choice. Okay, which terminal can follow A in the sentinel path? Okay, so this was regarding the theory of recursive predictive parsing. So I think for a long time we are discussing. And this is a subject, it can, you know, very easily make you confused. So, yes, you just joined. So, what I am asking that you take 10 minutes of break, okay? From 11:30 again, we will start. And ask your friend to join, okay? Why this, why your attendance is too low? Yes, we will start again from 11:30. We are taking a break. You ask your friends to join that time. Okay, don't leave the meeting, the class. Okay, just be online. I will start again after some time. I have spoken about recursive predictive parsing. Now, here you can see non-recursive predictive parsing. So, you can see this diagram. It is, this diagram is written predictive parsing. Okay, so it is a general model of predictive parsing. So the parser program, it have to take decision and all, is here. Okay, it have a input stream. Okay, whatever, you know, string you give as input, that instruction that it read token by token, and this is a, you can think this is a read head, this is a read head, you can assume, and it reads left to right. Okay, left to right it reads. And it also has a stack where it keeps all the non-terminals. And here definitely it will be terminals. Okay. And what parts table we had created, that will be here. So what do you think about this program? What this program does, it search for the match A ID or A alpha, okay, and this alpha is basically comes from here, okay, and this A, it basically comes from here, okay, and this program, this is the decision maker at the time of generating the output. Output, what is the output here? Parse tree. Parse tree, okay? So, this program need to decide every time which rule to drive to generate the parse tree, right? So, the top of the stack becomes A, this becomes, you know, say some alpha, and using this, it try to, you know, find out the match A alpha, which will, I know that this decision tree can give. Listen, this parse table can give. Okay, so using this parse table, it will find what production rule is there for match A alpha, and that production rule gives as output, and that is used to drive the parse tree. Okay, so non-recursive predictive parsing is a table-driven parser. It has a table here. Okay, it is a top-down parser. So it is a top-down parser means start from the root to the bottom or to the leaves. Okay. It is also known as LL1 parser. Okay. Why it is called as LL1 parser? Why this LL? And why is this one? This L means the input will be read from left to right. This L means it will always do left most derivation. And this one means one look ahead. Okay, so this is what we need to know. Why it is called? Yeah, this is what. Why it is called as LL1 parser? Parsing. Okay. So in